For instance,
our regional body headed by Archibald Corbin, the Greater Accra Regional Body, is actively going around looking at flood-prone areas, the reasons why the flood happens, what do we need to do? We need to move quickly in to make sure that we dredge gutters that are not dredged, in collaboration with other ministries, other agencies. We see how best we could dredge the gutters to allow the water
NADMO
to pass.
Dredging gutters?
Yes, it's part of our responsibility if we want to prevent the situation from happening. We have earth moving equipment sitting down in the head office. So we are as much as possible deploying those machines into the gutters to drain gutters. And also, we're moving in to look at the flood-prone areas where people are not heeding to call, not to develop, yet proceeding to develop. For instance, if you go onto the Spintex Road, just where the new, before the Abattoir Junction, where the new road is being constructed, just after that, there is a gentleman who has filled the waterway, and the 48 Regiment engineers we went with that day, in their assessment said he's filled with more than 100 trips of sand, and he's leveling, just to allow him build an estate. And we've invited the owner of that property. We've told him you can't build there, it's wrong. And for that matter, we're going to pull down structures that have started coming up on that piece of land. Aside that, when you go onto the what's it called? Around the Lashibi area, I've forgotten how the popular name is called, but there is a big, big, huge land sitting there. And that is supposed to be a forest reserve area. It's supposed to be an area where the rainfall that comes from the Debris Mountains, when it all collects, it comes down. It gathers there, and from there recedes gradually into the lagoon, then into the sea. But people have started developing, and ECG is providing electricity poles to those areas for them to continue developing. We've spoken to ECG, and officially this week, NADMO is going to write to ECG to stop that exercise, so that we can get to demolish those buildings and bring down those buildings, so we can leave the land bare. So when it rains, we won't have flooding issues. And also, as part of our response plan for this year, we've decided to set up 4 response units across Accra, and the same will be replicated in other regions.
We're talking about Accra, but we would also like to know what's happening in the other regions.
Yes, in other regions, regional directors have not yet been appointed, but our zonal directors have been instructed to come out with ways through which we can put in emergency response units on the ground as soon as the rains setting, so that we can get emergency response immediately to know what step to take. So Greater Accra, for instance, we divided into 4. There will be 1 patrol response team around the Madina Adenta area. Another one will be around 18 Junction to A Life. That's the second one. The third one will do Sakaman Malam, and the fourth one will be around the Circle Odona coming to Adabaka to Alajo. And all these response units, we are not doing it alone as NADMO. We're doing it together with the 48 Engineers Regiment of the military, Ghana National Fire Service, and the ambulance unit and the police. We want to put that task force together. And our coordinators on the ground have been told, when the rains start, go out there and fish out for where the problems are. Report to the emergency control room, so that they would then give information to that to the team on the ground to move in immediately. So if there's reinforcement, we'll bring
more people. Sounds very interesting dimension being brought to NADMO operations, but the rains are here. Whether we like it or not, we have to brace up. What about education? How are you educating people to get to realize that they need to move from lowlands to higher grounds, especially just when the rain starts?
Happily, appropriation bill gone through. Now we have resources, little resources we can move out. Our education unit is already rolling out a program starting from this week. Right. We'll be out there going into the problem areas where we know low-lying areas, the wager area,
You need to come to our areas, south.
We'll be there. We'll be there to educate people
and other regions.
And identify those who can't relocate immediately because of housing. Identify a gathering point, an assembling point. When the rains start, we can put in emergency tents and provide emergency aid to those people so that they relieve, so that they can move there immediately the rain starts. We're putting in all these measures,
Mr. Abu Ramadan,
to make sure that NADMO is better.
We're grateful that you joined us. Thank you very much. Abu Ramadan is Deputy General, Director General, I beg your pardon. I'm used to saying General Secretary and all of that. Pardon me, Abu Ramadan, Deputy Director General of NADMO. Let's move away from